Welcome back. In this video, we are going to solve problem 4.41 that is taken from chapter number 4, Axial Load, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler, 9th edition. So statement is the 2040T6 aluminum rod AC is reinforced with firmly bonded A992 steel tube BC if the assembly fits snugly between the rigid support so that there is no gap at C. Determine the support reactions when the axial force of 400 kN is applied. The assembly is attached at D. So you can see this is the assembly and this is AB pipe which is made up of aluminum, that is rod AC, and this BC rod is of steel tube which are firmly attached with this AC clear with a strongly bonded, and when there is a 400 kilonewton load is applied and there provided there is no gap at the end, so you have to find the reaction force at C as well as at D. So let's start with the solution, and we will start here that there will be no gap because this is given in the question. So due to this 400 kilonewton load, there will be extension in this rod AB causing the reaction force to apply it at point D will be FD, and when it is applying a load, so there will be a compression, so as a result FC will be here, and this FC will be equal to FC load taken by the steel plus FC load taken by aluminum. So I will draw the free body diagram over here. You can see I have drawn it. So we'll find this. This is the force FD, this is FC of aluminum and FC of steel. So first equation of equilibrium that we will apply is that sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero and upward force is taken as positive. So FD is acting upward minus this 400 kilonewton load, so 400 into 10 raised to power 3 plus this FC of aluminum plus FC of steel, there that will be equal to zero. This will be your equation number one. Now you can see that we have these three unknowns clear, so this question becomes statically indeterminate. For that, what we will do is that you can see this is the original scenario with no gap, so we will split this into two. First one is this one and second one is this one. In first scenario, we will take this load and we'll remove this support. Clear? We will remove this support. So due to this load, there will be extension in this portion AB. This will be extension because upward load is in this direction and 400 kilonewton load is in this direction. So it will cause the elongation in this, which is represented as delta P. And then we will take another scenario in which this load, there will be no load, and you can see that when there is a reaction load from FC, which is the combination of these two loads, and thus it is producing compression, so which will bring back to the original position. So we'll find this elongation and this compression, and we will find the unknown forces. So for that we will use compatibility equation. So compatibility equation. So what is the compatibility equation is that you can see in overall when you applied this force, this there is no gap here and here, so net change in length will be equal to zero, so that will be zero, and that change in length will be equal to delta P plus change in length due to this force FC. Clear? And this is equal to zero, so we will get delta P plus delta F C. Now here you can see from due to this load delta P will be equal to, as we know that change in length is equal to force into length divided by A into E. So what we will do is that force here which is producing tension is this is 400 and this is upward load FD. So we will take this 400 newton load, so 400 kilonewton into 10 raised to power 3 multiply by its length. Its length you can see that is 400. So 400 divided by area. What is the area of this tube? So let me show you here. You can see that the smaller tube having radius 25 millimeters. So its radius will be, its area will be equal to pi r square. Okay. So pi multiplied by r square, and r is 25 in meter, it is 0.025 square. And what is the value of E? So E from property, average mechanical property, you can see for aluminum it is 73.1 gigapascal. So 73.1 into 10 raised to power 9 gigapascal. Now this was a change in length due, and it is causing elongation. Now we'll find this delta FC, and this delta FC will be equal to, now you can see here we have one assembly is this one, which is firmly joined with this, clear, and second one is this one. So this one is the combination of two material, so they are bonded together, so they will move with the same displacement. So we will take one of the material and we will take the aluminium. So for that we will take FC of aluminium, so that is equal to FC of aluminium into its length, which is 800. So 800 divided by its area, which is pi into 0.025 square into E is 73.1 into 10 to the power 9, plus we will have the compression in this portion, because you can see the load is downward and upward load is this one. So the total load in this portion will be equal to FC of aluminum plus FC of steel into its length, and length is, you can see here the length is 400 millimeter for this portion AB. So I will write 400 divided by same area pi multiplied by 0.025 square into E is 73.1 into 10 to the power 9. But you can see that this deformation or displacement will be negative because this is causing compression. So put all these values in this equation, so you will get 0 is equal to 400 multiplied by 10 to the power 3 multiplied by 400 divided by pi multiplied by 0.025 square into 73.1 into 10 to the power 9 minus this value. So for that I will copy all this term so that I should not write them again. So let me copy it and I will paste it over here. So this will be the value. Okay. So from here you can see if you move this term to the right side, so that will be equal to 400. Okay. If you move to the right side, so FC of aluminum multiplied by 800 divided by pi multiplied by 0.025 square multiplied by 73.1 into 10 to the power 9 plus this FC of aluminum plus FC of steel multiplied by 400 divided by this term pi multiplied by 0.025 square multiplied by 73.1 into 10 to the power 9. That will be equal to 400 multiplied by 10 to the power 3 multiplied by 400 divided by pi multiplied by 0.025 whole square into 73.1 into 10 to the power 9. And you can see you have all these terms common in this three. So they will cancel each other. So what we will left is that 800 times FC for aluminum plus 400 FC for aluminum plus 400 FC for steel will be equal to 400 multiplied by 10 raised to power 3 multiplied by 400. Okay, so this will give you 1200 Fc for aluminum plus 400 Fc for steel is equal to 400 into 10 raised to power 3 multiplied by 400. If you divide 400 on both sides, let me divide it. So this will give us 300 Fc of aluminum plus Fc of steel will be equal to 400 into 10 raised to power 3. That this is your equation number 2. Now we will use another equation, that since these two materials are bonded over here, so elongation in both will be same. So it means that change in length of BC, that is steel, will be equal to change in length of this portion BC that is made up of aluminum. So we will use this equation. Also, I will write it over here that change in length of BC of steel will be equal to change in length of BC for aluminum. So for that, we will know that this will be equal to Fc of steel into its length, which is how much? Which is 800. Let me show you here. You can see the length of BC is 800 divided by area. So area will be pi into r square. So for steel, r is how much? That is 50 millimeter. So I can write it, since it is hollow because there is inner of aluminum, so it will be pi into 50 square minus 25 square, but that is in millimeter. So in meter it will be 0.05 whole square minus 0.025 whole square will be the area of steel. Okay, so I will write it 0.05 whole square minus 0.025 whole square multiply by E of steel. So E of steel, I have written the value over here, that is 200 gigapascal. So 200 into 10 raised to power 9 gigapascal. And similarly, delta BC for aluminum will be equal to FC for aluminum multiply by its length, which is 800 divided by area pi r square. So r is for aluminum, it is 0.025 square into E. E for aluminum is 73.1 gigapascal. That is 73.1 into 10 raised to power 9. And you can see this will cancel with this, clear? And when you take this F of steel in term of F of aluminum and simplify, it will be 8.2079 F of C for aluminum. This is your equation number 3. So put equation 3 in equation 2. So when you put the value of F of steel in here, clear? So what you will get is that, due to shortage of time, I will write it that when you put the value of F of steel over here, so what you will get, that Fc of aluminum will be equal to 35.689 kilonewton. Okay. Now when you get this F of steel, so put Fc of aluminum in equation number 3. So this is your equation number 3. So you will get Fc for steel will be equal to how much? That will be 29.293 kilonewton. Okay. Now we have this. So at last we will find the total reaction force in this equation. You can see here, we know that this F of steel plus F of aluminum, they are combinedly give you this Fc. So I will write it that Fc will be equal to Fc of steel plus Fc of aluminum. And when you put the value, what was the value? These are two values. So you can just plug it. Fc of steel was 292.93 plus Fc of aluminum is 35.689, and when you add them you will get Fc will be equal to how much? That is 329 kilonewton. So this is the value of Fc. Now when you get Fc, so what I will choose in another color, red color, put in equation 1 the value of Fc. So this is your equation number 1. So when you put it, you will get Fd will be equal to 71.4 kilonewton. So this is the reaction force Fd and Fc. Both are these answers of our question, which is generated when a load of 400 kilonewton applied on this statically indeterminate rod. And that was all about this problem 4.41. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Thank you for watching.